Yes, we'll worry about that when the time comes, eh? Come on, I'll take you to the laundry. Introduce you to some of the women.
Ladies, I'd like you all to meet Sarah, to meet Jackie Nolan.
Hello, love. What are you in for?
Fletch said to call you something else, didn't he, Jackie?
Yes, Sarah Forrest. That's the name I used on the outside.
Now, wait a minute. Nolan. Nolan, you're not the one that was involved in that escape from Barnhurst a few years ago, are you? The one that wasn't caught?
Well, not until now, anyway.
Well, what do you know? Anyone can stay out in the loose that long and not get caught deserves a medal. I'm Bea Smith. Come with the others. This is Lizzie Birdsworth.
G'day.
Your mouth's open, Lizzie.
Where'd you hide all that time?
Listen, we'll discuss that later and have a tea party. This is Chrissy Latham. She's a bit low at the moment. Her kid was sent to hospital sick and got snatched.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And over here we have Judy Bryant. This is the lady to like if you like ladies. And then we have Robin and Bev and Rita. But tell me, I'm dying of curiosity. Where have you been all these years?
Well, pretty close by. I changed my name and a friend gave me a job in his interior design shop. It was going really well, too.
So how come you're in here?
You wouldn't believe it. Your governor, Mrs. Davidson, came in to inquire about having some work done. She recognised me and...
Don't tell me Davo dobbed you in.
Well, she didn't really have much choice, did she?
Strike a like, how bloody ridiculous. They're always screaming about rehabilitation, and there you are, as clean as a whistle, with a decent job, and what the hell do they do?
Hello?
Oh, Dr. Marshall? Erica Davidson.
Erica, my dear. We were just talking about you last night. Well, you must come out to dinner soon. We haven't seen you for so long.
I'd love to.
Now, what can I do for you? Not a professional call, I hope.
Yes, actually, but not for me. One of our officers needs a few days' rest. I won't go into the reasons, but I would consider it a favor if you could issue a medical certificate for her. It saves explanations with the department.
I see. Well, of course, I'd have to examine her first.
Oh, yes, yes, of course, I understand that. When would you be able to see her?
Well, I'm pretty busy right now, but, as it's for you, I'll see if I can pop around this afternoon.
I really do appreciate it.
Oh, not at all. Besides, pays to keep on the right side of the governor.
Oh, yes. Now, I better give you her name and address.
Right.
Yes?
I'm Dr. Marshall. Are you Vera Bennett?
Well, I don't understand. I didn't call a doctor.
Oh, Erica Davidson asked me to come and see you.
Come in.
Thank you.
I don't understand why Mrs. Davidson would have done that. I'm perfectly healthy.
Well, actually, she mentioned the fact that you needed a few days off. So, if I examine you and make out a medical certificate, the department won't ask any questions.
But I'm not ill. I don't know why Mrs. Davidson would want to deceive the department.
I'm sure she wouldn't dream of it, unless, of course, she thought you had a perfectly good reason.
But this will make it seem as if there's really something wrong with me.
Oh, I've known Erica for a long time. I don't think she'd deliberately embarrass anybody. Do you?
I suppose not.
Then why not let me get on with the examination? I mean, at the very least, you'll get a few days' good rest. I'm sure you work very hard at Wentworth.
We all do.
Good. Now, all Erica said was that you needed a few days off. I don't know what's going on, but a good rest shouldn't be too hard to take, should it?
Well, I have been feeling tired lately. All right. I don't see what harm it can do.
Very good. Excellent.
Well, sister...
Just where have you been? The police are looking for you.
I know. They just came round to my place. Isn't it terrible about Elizabeth? I couldn't believe it.
Oh, me either. I just looked into a cot and there it was, empty.
Kidnapped, that's what the police called it. I wonder who could have done it.
Well, we thought it was...
That'll do, thank you, nurse. Get back to work.
Okay, sister. Now, I'd like an explanation from you. What happened to you this morning?
Gee, I'm real sorry, sister, but I felt crook, so I went home. I know I should have checked with you first, but I forgot. And it wasn't until the police came round that I remembered that I should have, so I came straight back here as soon as they'd left.
If you're feeling ill, perhaps you'd better report to casualty.
Oh, it's all right. I went to my own doctor and he gave me something. But I'm real sorry about leaving the way I did. Won't happen again, honest.
It had better not. I'm going to have to report it to the superintendent, you know.
Yeah, I suppose you will.
I still think this is ridiculous. I'm perfectly healthy, aren't I?
Well, I couldn't find anything seriously wrong.
There. I told you. Now, I really can't go along with this.
this conspiracy against the department, I don't need a medical certificate.
Come now, Miss Bennett. I think conspiracy is going a bit far, don't you? Whether or not you'd like to admit it, you're very run down, and you need a good rest. You don't seem to realize that people are only trying to help you. It's a prescription for a tonic. That and some rest should help you.
But I think I'm...
You may think, Miss Bennett, but I know. Perhaps that's why I'm a doctor and you're not. Good day.
Jim.
Good night.
Jackie settling in all right?
Yes, I suppose so.
Must be very difficult for you with her in here.
I'll manage. Look, Meg, if you don't mind, I'd rather not talk about it.
Of course. I'm sorry.
I'd like to see Jackie Nolan, please. The name's Phillips.
Don't you think it'd be wiser to let her settle in first?
What's the matter, Mr. Fletcher? Don't you want me to see her?
I don't want to see her upset.
I've just spent most of the day consulting with her solicitors to try and find ways of getting her out of here. As far as I can see, all you've done is get her in. Now, which do you think she might find more upsetting?
If you just sign in here, please, I'll take you through to the interview room.
Thank you.
Well, it was a bit of a coincidence, old Davo coming into the shop, wasn't it? Not a very pleasant one, though.
Well, it wasn't really. Jim Fletcher recommended us to her.
How come?
Well, Jim and I have been seeing a bit of each other. We met at a party. The only trouble was, when we met, I didn't know he was a screw, and he certainly didn't know who I was.
Oh, cool. That must have been a bit of a shock.
Yes, you could say that.
Must have given him a turn when he found you in here.
Well, not really. Actually, he advised me to turn myself in.
Oh, all men are bastards.
I don't think he's a bastard. Actually, I'm rather fond of him.
Of him? How can you be fond of him when he dubbed you in?
I wouldn't touch a bloke like that with a barge pole.
Now, look, it had nothing to do with him. Erica Davidson recognized me. All Jim did was advise me to turn myself in instead of waiting for the police to come and pick me up. He let me make up my own mind. I'm grateful to him.
There's a visitor for you, Nolan. Mrs. Jackson's taking him to the interview room.
Thank you, Mr. Fletcher.
Well, now, there's a turn-up for the books.
I'm sorry, the rules are no physical contact.
Oh, for heaven's sake, what do you think I've done? Smuggled a file in or something?
He doesn't make the rules, Julian.
Yeah. Look, I've been talking to the solicitors most of the day, and they seem to think that they can base their case on the success you've made of your life outside, you know. Self-rehabilitation and all that sort of thing. Plus the fact that the business would go broke without you. It will, you know. Anyway, they seem to think that you'll get a lot of sympathy when it's discovered that you'll be right back where you started and broke as well.
Do they think they can get me off completely?
I'd like to say yes, but it looks like whatever happens, you're going to have to serve out your original sentence.
Oh.
It's not that bad. Looks like you mightn't have to do any extra time.
Yeah.
Well, what do I tell them? I mean, do they sound all right? They'll have to come and see you.
Look, you do what you think's best. Yeah, they sound all right to me. I don't really care what happens as long as I don't have to serve any extra time. That's the most I can hope for anyway.